Right, hello again. Right, we're at Laguna Seca with the RUF GT3 challenge again. This is actually my third race.
I'm just happy to make the main event.
Because I've screwed up the sound on the first two for various reasons. So hopefully the sound will be good on this one and we'll get a proper race. Oh.
Green, green, green. Right side, clear, right side. Stay on the left. Clear on the right.
Wow, this guy's a bit all over the place.
Right side. Clear on the right.
Well, I didn't intend to wreck him. In fact, I didn't even intend to go down the inside of him there, but... he was kind of making his mistakes on every corner. We'll have to have a look at that at the end. Car seems okay. Right, let's settle down and start sticking in some decent laps.
Thanks, Derek.
1:26.883.
Not really risking it much. Figured you would be a good one to follow anyway.
Car right. Stay on the left, clear on the right.
Well, that's about as fast as I can go, so. And he's still getting away from me. Shows the difference between a tidy lap and a scruffy lap. There's a whole second. So I should really try to be keeping them tidy. I was going to say, the guy that's leading it, Sylvain, he's pro license, so it's no surprise that he's a mile in front. Garrett Gress behind us. Looks like I can stay in front of him if I don't make any screw ups. So it looks like it's fourth. Unless I get freebies.
You're left out.
1 minute 26.946.
I'm going to have an investigate of why I'm missing downshifts. I mean, I'm using auto blip. Maybe they've made it like the C-spec, whereas auto blip's not the way to go. Well, this guy's being an annoying dick. And there he goes.
Thanks, Gordon.
I've lost my little gap to the guy behind, unfortunately, so... getting a little bit raggedy around there now. Need to calm it all down a notch.
Minute
26.349. Not as bad. With the tyre wear, that's probably where I am in terms of pace. Well, not been involved in any big carnage so far, so we might even stay on the lead lap this time, which against the pro world class driver. It's not a bad thing even in itself. So there he is, 28 seconds behind us. And Derek's made a little mistake, so.
Slow car ahead, car stop on the left. Go right.
That was a scary moment. Luckily he didn't pick the moment I was coming around the corner to move. Cost me a second though, looking at that.
Minute
don't want to be letting Derek catch up too much. So if I stay on the lead lap, it will probably be 22 laps at the... Nearly binned it there. But the pace Sylvain's doing, it'll probably be a 22 lap race. Stop making mistakes and focus. Better? And that's better as well. I must remember to save the replay and have a look at some of Sylvain's laps, because I bet they must be spectacularly good. Thank you. suspect it'll look like he's having a really easy time of it when we have a look at his onboard. Might be one of these less is more type of tracks.
1 minute 27.391.
That cost me more time. I've not been so lucky with the traffic this time. Derek's binned it or disconnected or something. Well, looks like I am going to get lapped. That didn't look particularly smooth. He brakes like twice in that corner. Spot us happy today. even though I actually lost a place from where I started. Made up about 9 places yesterday and he was pissed off with me. So. He's a funny old stick, that spotter. Actually, let's go far chase for now. Oh, this guy was really all over the place. Which is not what you want when you want to try and settle into a race. Wow, it all kicked off behind me. So I did catch him. But I wasn't even trying to overtake him, I was just going from a normal braking point. Hold up. It's kind of like he's taking his line regardless of what's around him. Okay, mostly my fault, but he was kind of difficult to race against, which is my excuse. So, let's have a look at the first lap, and then we'll do the incidents. So many runners was there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12, that's interesting, because I thought there was 15 registered. Maybe some guys started from the pit. Oh, I wonder if the guy behind me got disqualified. I wonder if he picked up just one too many 1Xs. I saw him picking up a lot of 1Xs in the mirrors, I must admit, particularly here. Okay, let's go to the incidents. Okay, that's our man. Needs a bit. Oh, that was the next lap. Don't know what was up with that. That's the trouble with this track. The instant finder picks up a lot of 1Xs. That's another one. It should be called the 1X Finder. It's going to be a slowdown. And that's what a pro driver looks like going about his business. You can see the lack of effort going on. Take a couple of onboard laps of them at the end of the session. Okay, it's quite a big off track. So that must have been the guy that was chasing me. That was Derek. Nice paint. You think when you go back looking through the incidents, you're going to get lots of carnage at the Laguna Seca, but you get as a litany of... Ooh. Oh. Sylvain Pomerard, I'll have a look at on board. Unfortunately, without looking at his dash and his inputs, you can only get a kind of rough idea of what he's doing. Well, there's car 15. well, it kind of looks from this, so this can be deceptive, that he's I don't know. Doesn't look like he's doing much different to me, in all honesty. He's just doing it better. Okay, that's a lot better. They make it look so easy, don't they, good drivers?